CVS? CVS, with CVS. And for some reason, I don't know why, but I have been snoring pretty heavily the last couple days. And,
last couple of days?
Just be nice. And I have been snoring pretty
heavily.
Shut up! And so I go out, and I buy this little thing, okay? It looks like that, okay? It's behind that. And you stick it up inside your nose, and you're supposed to wear it all night. I sneezed. I lost it. And so, we don't know what it is, so I guess the snoring thing is still an issue with us. I don't have an answer for it here. So tonight, we're talking about evangelism. We're talking about, this is the third lesson in this series. And it deals with, you know, how to share your faith, or how to tell others that you're a Christian. And I know Brian got saved this summer, and so did Edward. And, you know, the question comes, okay, I'm a Christian. Oh, Ariel, I didn't mean to leave you out, I'm so sorry. And so the question comes, you have these friends, you have this family, okay, all of a sudden you're supposed to be different, but everything else is still the same. And so what do you do as a result of that? How do you tell them? How do you react? What are you supposed to do? I think this is a very fundamental thing that can catch us off guard if we're not careful, because all of a sudden, I'm a Christian, and then you go back to the home, and it's really hard. And you've got friends, and you don't want to give up those friends, but, you know, they're not Christians, but, you know, you're supposed to be a good Christian witness to them, but, you know, it's hard. And I know it's hard. And so tonight, I'm going to give you a couple things, and we're going to talk about things. I'm going to give you like six nuggets. Like six? A, B, C, D, E, F. Yeah, six nuggets. Five. A, B, C, D, E. Five nuggets. About how to handle when you get saved, how to tell people about your Christian experience, okay? I want you to imagine you've experienced spending 3 years with Jesus, okay? And you're one of the disciples, and you spent 3 years with him. And he gave you all this great information. He filled you full of the Spirit. He gave you knowledge and wisdom. He told you about who God was. And then, you know, you saw him do miracles, feed 5,000, feed a bunch of other people here. He healed the lame, he made the blind see, and all that cool stuff. You saw him die. And you're pretty depressed about the whole thing, but you know, he did say he'd come back, so you're pretty pumped about that. And then a couple days later, he rises from the dead. And you can spend a little bit more time with him. And then he gives you a command. He says, what I want you to do, I've spent 3 years with you. Your job is to go out and tell other people about what you experienced. And I want you to think, the entire world, you're sitting here at this church because of an experience that 12 people had 2,000 years ago. Because of their witness and how they went out and shared the gospel, you know, with the entire world. And there's only 12 people there. In this room, there's far more than 12 people. And God's giving you all different talents, different abilities. Just like the original disciples, he's giving you different people to minister to. You know, Meg is a different person from Elaine. They kind of have different friends. Except for Morgan, I'm sorry. And I'm teasing. But God has put you guys, all of y'all, in different places in this world. At your schools, some of you guys are in high school, some of you are in middle school, some of you shouldn't be in high school but are in middle school because you failed or whatever. But God's got you in a particular place at a particular time because he wants you to do a ministry there. Okay? And he's got a place where there's a verse in Romans. It's Romans 1:16. I'm going to read this for you guys. It says, I'm not ashamed of the gospel because it is the power of God for the salvation of everyone who believes. First the Jews and then the Gentiles. There is power in salvation. God has given you a gift and he wants you to share it. It's not something that you should be ashamed of. And so first, you're a Christian. You just got saved this summer. What do you do? What do you say? What do you say to your friends? You know, hey, you've got these friends who aren't Christians. What do you tell them?
I got saved.
You know, how do you go off and say that without sounding really cheesy or completely disconnecting them and making them feel like, you know, I don't want nothing to do with you? I think there's three things that are going to happen, three possibilities. As soon as you make it known, because it's your job to let them know you're a Christian, either through something you say, hey, let me tell you what happened with me last summer. Or maybe it's something, just your change in attitude. You know, there's something, you got to tell them that you became a Christian. Otherwise, you're denying Christ, and you're not telling them, you know, hey, I'm a Christian, you're kind of hiding. That's not a good thing. There's three things that can happen, I think. The first one is, you know, hey, let me tell you, Meg, I got saved this summer. Ain't it cool? You can say, well, that's pretty cool, but, you know, I don't need Jesus. You know, I'm good enough as it is. You know, and that's one possibility, don't you think? They can say that they don't need that. They're fine. They're defending their place with God. They're defending their position with God. The second thing could be, hey, Meg, I got saved this summer. And you can respond, shoot, I don't want nothing to do with you, Jesus weirdo. And they can walk out. You know, that's another possibility, right? You know, you get saved. You tell your friends about Christ. And it's very possible they can want absolutely nothing to do with you after that. I think there's a third opportunity, too. And, you know, I said, hey, Meg, I got saved this summer. And you can say something to the point, well, you know, I always had questions about that. Can we talk? You know, maybe you'll fall in between there someplace. Ariel, maybe when you told your friends, you know, you got saved, maybe you had a little bit different reaction. But are you prepared for the reaction? Have you thought about how you're going to tell your friends? But it's not if you tell, but when you tell and what you say. Because it's our job to tell. It's our job to reach out to those people and say, hey, I got saved. And so, you know, I want you guys to think about that. How are you going to handle your friends? How do you handle your friends every day who aren't Christians in the schools? How do you tell them? Do you act the same way regardless of whether or not you got saved or not? Are you exactly the same? I think there's another group, and I think this is even tougher than your friends. It's your parents. How do you handle your parents when you get saved? Especially those of you guys who don't have parents who are in church. How do you handle that? How do you talk to your mom or your dad and say, hey, just so you know, the person you knew that summer, that's not me. I've changed. I've become a new person. And especially when this person watched you up as a baby and seen you your entire life. How do you, because you know you love, you know you want them to have the same joy you do. How do you tell them that, hey, I got saved. I want you to know about it. I don't know if you guys have thought about it. There's a couple things you need. First of all, you need to remember that your parents are still your parents. No matter what decision you made this summer or what decision you're going to make in the future, you still need to respect your parents and obey them. If you want to be a good Christian child or teenager, the best thing you can do is obey your parents and love them through obeying. Now, I know there's going to be situations where they're pretty whacked out and, you know, they have no idea what's going on there. And she's nodding in serious agreement because her ponytail's hitting her face every time she does that. But, you know, there's... Wade's like, what? She's hitting me. But there's going to be situations where, you know, your parents aren't Christians and you need to tell them. And so, but you're still going to go away. Secondly, the most important thing you can do to your parents, and I'm not picking on you, girl, but I know you guys say it, is, you know, she came and saw you get baptized. I think that's really cool. But you need to tell them what happened to you. If you get saved or God's doing something in your life, tell your parents. Let them know. You know what's going to happen? They're going to be a little bit convicted about how you found a sense of joy, but they don't possibly. Or if they're saved and they're not going to church, guess what? If you start going to church, say, hey, Mom, I want to go to church, you'll probably get them to eventually come around and say, well, maybe there's something going on. Maybe I'm off the track a little bit. And maybe they'll start going to church. I can't guarantee it every time, I know. But God, it's not a 100% thing. You know, you need to try your best at it. I don't know. I'm sorry. You shouldn't do that. The third thing is, show them the change. You know, it's one thing to say, I got saved. And then to still do all the bad stuff you used to do and still get in trouble like you used to, if you show them there's a difference in your life, they will recognize it and they'll start questioning. You may not think they're questioning, but I promise you, there's something inside of them that's saying, hey, my child did something. They made a difference. And, you know, I didn't see what's going on. So, that's a third one. And I think a really cool one is if you find your parents and see if they have a need and try to meet it. Now, none of this stuff is necessarily straight out Bible, but I think it's very practical.